Hey SnowRunner fans, today we're going to take a look at the Pacific P16 JBE Dual Front. Say that 30 times fast. No, go ahead, I'll wait. Alright, so the dual front refers to the fact that it can have dual front tires, and this is not true with every single tire that it has available, but it's certainly true with enough of them to make the aspect interesting. The dual front tires add some buoyancy for the mud. For example, as you'll see here, once I pop it into all-wheel drive, of course, and get some traction going. See, there we go. Now for a big truck, that is certainly cutting through the mud, I gotta tell you. You see that lag there? Yeah, that's a precursor to a crash, old blue screen and everything, and I'm still certain that it has to do with memory issues due to the console mods, which this is one of course. Once I freed up some more memory, the issue seemed to have resolved itself for now. Now we're off to the quarry, and we'll see again, as I mentioned earlier, that the dual front tires actually add more stability and I don't know about maneuverability. This is a big truck. It takes a bit of work to get this thing to move around, but as you'll see, it handles the quarry with ease, considering what a large truck it is. I don't skimp on the shortcuts or whatever, and there are lots of trucks that would suffer from going through here the same way that I do with this one, but this one just handles it. No problems, no worries. I was a bit reluctant at first to take the shortcut down because it's rather narrow and windy, and this is a pretty big truck and even bigger with the dual tires, dual wheels all the way around. But I put it back in automatic so I could have easy access to forward and reverse without shifting. Or maybe I put it back in low. The reason I do actually is because, especially on the way down, more control having it in low. Of course, we need to put the all-wheel drive on again, as we did earlier. That'll be a big help. Well, now that I've freed up about a little over 3 gigabytes of space for the mods, I'm pretty sure that I'm not going to have the problem with the blue screen crash. And I'm equally certain, I think, that I'm not going to get the same kind of lags that you'll see in the first two clips in this particular video. In the last clip, we don't see any lags. Mind you, it's a very short clip, the last one, but still, they were happening pretty regularly, and they were very obvious, so. All right, we're almost at the bottom of the quarry. Am I gonna take the shortcut? Of course I am. This truck will go anywhere without even a scratch. I painted it red because this is a Canadian truck, the Pacific P16. It comes from out in BC and Alberta, where they do all the logging in the Rockies. So it should be no surprise that this truck can handle itself. It is a real beast. Real badass of a truck for sure. huge wheels. Now, one of the things that JBE has added to this is the all-wheel drive, because I don't believe that's present on the original Pacific P16. I'd have to check in the game. I haven't taken a look at it in a while, but I believe that's something that's an addition in this mod as well. Alright, we're up near the top now. We made it back up through there with relative ease, I gotta say. So, this last hill should be nothing for this guy. Come on, dude. Up we go. Yeah. Easy stuff. Nice looking truck too. You can tell it's big, just look at that thing. Huge. Alright, now we're in the Yukon for our last trial, where we put the truck through the cascading water. Yeah. Usually the big trucks don't like this. It's really, the small trucks do quite well here, but the big trucks don't like it very much. This P16, on the other hand, is, again, once I put it in all-wheel drive, not having any problems with the current whatsoever. Very good. So if you found this video helpful or entertaining, please hit subscribe, like, and share. I'd appreciate it. And in the meantime, stay safe, take care of yourself, and until next time, bye for now.